It has been found that at times of great despair, humans tend to make the greatest choices. Which is why I decided that I should sleep only for 3 hours, and that I should fix my mic. Yes, there's no fan anymore, and do you want to know the glorious reason that it had a fan? There was a noise suppression button. This whole time, it wasn't anything on OBS. I just had to go to the mic settings themselves, and then as soon as I opened, I saw mic suppression. And it was turned off. Why was it turned off? I clicked just one button and everything was immediately better. Oh, the human brain is just a wide source of intelligence. It is clearly just unexplored. So basically, now that I'm running on 3 hours of sleep, I found that this would be the best amount, this would be the right amount of time, where we should make another episode of our great new series, Dawn from Technoblade, where we tell college stories. Because this is actually pretty cool to talk about, because do you think I get to talk about college to anyone? Who do you even talk about college to? College friends! That's not happening. That's not a thing that's existing. So we're basically continuing our order of... this person's fighting someone else. So, okay, there you are. So we're basically continuing our order of going in order of descending. So, like, we're going through what happened before. And, like... what happened before was, well, pretty much the semester started. So, like, the story we have today is a story that's still ongoing, but it's one that's, you know, just fun enough because even the fact that it's happened itself is worth talking about. And this is the story of how the Dream SMP is dominating my last semester of college. Because, like, I'm on my third year, and I've got, like, this is the last semester of the third year. Supposedly, you're meant to finish the course in the semester if you pass the subjects, which is something I'm not doing. But it's fine, don't worry about it. So what is my great idea? My great idea is that we have the subject English. It is the place where our story will take today. But English, the great subject where I do amazing oral presentations. And, you know, it's regular English. Do you think it's about reading? No, this isn't America. This is... English is a foreign language here, so, like, it's about learning grammar and vocabulary. And if you couldn't tell by the fact that I'm doing YouTube in English for I don't know how many years, I can kind of speak the language. So it's the easiest subject I've ever had. And it's the only one that I'm always guaranteed to pass, no matter what. So, the thing about English this semester is that in the other semesters before this, we had to do an oral presentation. Usually in groups, but this time the oral presentation was canceled, which is just like, what? How am I meant to make my jokes now? The oral presentations were like my one source of making jokes. What am I meant to do? But, you know, unfortunately, it was replaced with another 25% of our grade going to a writing essay with academic writing, which just means that, you know, we have to use sources. We have to, like, use academic studies. All of those things to prove our points. And, you know, it's all fancy and it requires a lot more work. Sharpness 4! And basically, that is the thing that we have to do. But the good part is that the teacher said that we were free to choose whatever topic we liked. It didn't have to be something that, you know, was on the syllabus for the semester or anything. We could pick our own topic as long as the teacher was okay with it. Which, immediately, I just go like, alright, what is the dumbest, funniest topic I can talk about? That way I feel motivated in college. Because do you think I feel motivated in college? I mean, like, there's a virus happening. I don't have classes in real life. It's all online through a screen. We win. And basically, like, the next game is about to start. Oh, look, there's a dream in a present place. Fantastic. Like, do you think that I feel motivated towards college? It's all online. There's legit no motivation. I require people. I'm an introvert that requires people to be happy. What a sad and cruel reality it is. Give me a sharp 4. Sharp 4! So basically, I decide that I should talk about the Dream SMP. And basically, even in that same first class where the teacher, like, opened up the semester and explained what the writing assignment was going to be, I just straight up said, oh, come on, this guy's just, you just stole my fight. I wanted to fight him. Oh, you're letting me fight him? Oh, let's go. He's like, I legit told him, like, teacher, could you stay a bit after class so I could talk about, like, the topic? I already figured it out, and I want to see if you're okay with it. Because, like, I was already, like, the dream SMP. Because, you know, basically in my off time, all I'm watching is Technoblade and Rambo nowadays. So it's just, there was nothing else in my head. You think of what? I was going to talk about the Cuban Revolution. That's already, that's the last video. I'm not talking about that. So basically, like, but how was I going to get the teacher to say yes to an essay about the, to an academic essay, no less, about the dream SMP? Now, obviously, you got to sell the essay. And a good idea for selling essays is that a thing that teachers love is getting something that's not vague as a topic. Something that's, something that's like super specific. They just love it because other people, when they present their topic ideas, they just go like racism, sexism, social media. And that is like their entire first idea for a topic. And the teachers are just like, no. No, that's too wide. You can't talk about that like that. You need to do something more specific to, like, sexism in the advertisements in the 80s or something like that. But, like, when he heard me, and I'm like, so I'm going to talk about the pandemic and its effect on social media. Because the thing about the pandemic is that, like, gaming just completely loved the social, the pandemic. I mean, not for all the deaths and stuff, but because so many people's viewers just massively increased and, like, Twitter's been broken ever since. I just want to point that out. Like, it's trending every day. Come on, this guy just chugged so much of his healing. You gotta die. So, like, the focus of the essay is to show how, like, a positive effect of the pandemic, which was, like, how social media and stuff changed, how entertainment's changed, you know, stuff like that. And my area of focus is going to be on a bunch of YouTubers called the Dream SMP because, you know, let's face it, they're the ones that grew the most. That TikToker, I've never heard about her. That's not important to my discussion. So basically, yeah, I'm only going to talk about Rambu, Tommy, Technoblade, and Dream himself, but still, you know, it's the Dream SMP. And basically, the way I decided to do it, because, like, I've already started it. Did you think this is a joke? What kind of college student do you take me for? Someone who wants to have a life and a career and a professional academic? No, I am someone who's making essays about the Dream SMP. You should have seen me last year. I made a presentation focusing on Yakuza. The video game. Oh my god. So basically, I've already got sources. I've already got studies and everything. You know, one good thing about making an academic essay about the Dream SMP, it's that there are so many sources. Like, you go to Social Blade, you go to the websites that track Twitch, there are so many sources that say, like, what's the highest amount of viewers someone has had on a live stream on YouTube? What's the highest amount of viewers someone's had on a live stream on Twitch? What's the person with the most subscribers on Twitch? You know, things like that. Why is he both spamming me, by the way? I never understood that part. So you basically, like, I have so many sources on that. And then I have all the studies on the mental health in the pandemic, because that's how I start. I start about talking about the pandemic, and now it canceled, like, all of these forms of entertainment, like sports, like movies, like TV shows, like series. All of that was just kind of canceled. And the problem with sticking back home is that the people need entertainment to be happy, and I found, like, studies that show that. And then after that, I am supposed to talk about, like, how social media, like, how gaming was the one that provided, and Disney Plus, and, like, yoga videos, but that's not important. We're only gonna talk about the Dream SMP because I am a fangirl that watches too much Technoblade. And basically, like, after that, we go on people's mental health and how they need to be entertained, and then that's where we talk about Minecraft and how Minecraft is actually the perfect game, because I'm gonna mention Fall Guys and Among Us, because they also had a big rise in the pandemic, especially Among Us. But, like, Minecraft did it even more, and I'm gonna, like, cite studies explaining, like, the meaning of nostalgia, like, how that directs people, you know, all that things. There's so many, like, mental health and psychology to do with a Dream SMP and, like, the need for entertainment. Like, even the fact that people spend so much time on live streams, like, more than they do on, like, recorded videos, that's a study in and of itself. I found that one already. Oh my god, the internet is so good for this. Because the topic is so recent, and not, again, like, the seventh battle of the war between America and Cuba. It's just fantastic. There's so many sources. I can easily find everything. It's just about having the time to do it. Which I don't, but, you know, enough 5 a.m. sleepless nights, we'll get to it eventually. So it's like, you think it's a joke, but it's actually a good topic that I can write so much about. Like, the other groups, they're going to pick serious topics because they're college students in their 20s, living their life, being super smart. It's like, oh, I'm just going to talk about the dream SMP. And it's going to be great. And I'm going to talk about, like, how the dream SMP is, like, the modern cartoon, which is something Mr. Beast pointed out, and I, like, completely agree with. But then you add the fact that the psychology is, like, it's like the where you have the fandoms for bands. So, like, you like a character in the show, but the difference is that you can actually talk to the character in live because of the streams, and that's what makes them so attractive. And, like, the fact that all of this can actually be put into academic writing, honestly, it's just, I love those surprises of life. It's just hilarious. And I should probably put a helmet in here. I'm gonna put a helmet. Okay, here you go, buddy. Actually, you know what? I should probably let you leave. You know what? You can leave. I'm gonna go over here. Just so, you know, we can combo. I want to kind of combo you a little. And if you're just there, I'm not really combo you. You are so good. Thank you. Thank you for your support. I'm sure everyone else would say that too when they read my English essay about the Dream SMP. Come on. I gotta get over here. And then after that, like, I'm going to end it with more of the community. Besides talking about, like, how Dream, Rambu, Tommy, and Techno, because they are all, like, growth is kind of different. But that's why I only took those four as a sample, besides those four being the ones I watched. But basically, like, after that, and I'm going to show on how, during the pandemic, it is important to have people that you talk to and basically a community. So that's where I bring up how the Dream SMP made people create a community, which, yes, I'm going to talk about stands. But it's the good ones! So basically, I'm going to talk about, like, how Dream SMP, like, I have that community that just straight up broke Twitter. You have artists like Saddest that make animations. You have singers like Kanaya and Precious Rulestone. I'm remembering these names right. You have cosplayers on TikTok. You have people writing appropriate fanfics that don't have any sort of child pornography in them. Yes. And all other kinds of, like, how the Dream SMP ended up making a community. So that is going to be the topic of my essay. Like, how actually, like, the Dream SMP is taking over my final college semester. And you think it's just English? Well, it's not. So, you know, if another subject called creative writing, where you kind of have to write stories. So what if you took the Dream SMP and made it into a literary text? I can't say anymore. Just in case the teacher somehow looks at this video and calls me out for plagiarism. Because of the fact is, I've already written 40 pages going from Aerith's betrayal to Techno joining the server. But I switched the names, and I added a lot of new scenes. But that's basically, like, how the Dream SMP is completely controlling two of my different subjects. Because I'm writing the story of the Dream SMP. Also, the fact that it's roleplay. The fact that it's roleplay is also kind of important for the essay itself. Because it makes them feel more human. And that's something that, like, is important for the viewers. Because, again, they're stuck at home. They're basically, yeah, lots of mental health stuff. Also, there's one thing that I didn't mention. Did I mention how this isn't a group work? No? That's because I'm doing it by myself again. Yeah, this is supposed to be a group work where you do it with, like, at least two other people for a group of three. Not at least two other people. The maximum is two other people for a group of three. But, you know, do you think anyone else in this college knows about the Dream SMP? I wouldn't think so. The most they ever knew was James Charles. And now I talked about how James Charles, you know, he was practicing for Minecraft Monday. And I killed him. It was a great day, I'll have you all know. Come here. That's the most they knew about Minecraft. But it's okay, because now we are just so motivated. And can you say that you in college are doing two different assignments? Oh my god, he had so much healing. This was the best choice that I've ever made. Are making, like, actual academic writing using sources for the Dream SMP. I don't think you do. I'm living my life to the fullest while people are writing about mathematics in the Bermuda Triangle. That's probably not what they're doing. you know, they're working in groups and I can just work by myself, which means I can just do whatever I want and make my own progress. It's great. We should try it more often. Working as a solo, it's just fantastic. But yeah, basically, we're going to end the story time after killing this guy. We're just going to peacefully let him anvil because, you know, people deserve to anvil. It's a very fair thing. I'm just trying to think of anything I didn't say because, like, obviously, I'm still working on the essay. I've only just now finished the pandemic part. Also, like, citing through APA on Harvard, like, reference lists. Oh, my God. It's so complicated. Usually what I used to do for bibliography is, like, you put the link of the website you went to. But no. They want names. They want dates. They want, like, the day that you visited the site for some reason. Like, come on. I don't want to put in my reference list that I went on these websites a day before the essay was due. Like, come on, do you think that is something I want to tell the teacher that I finished the essay literally a day before it's due? No, I don't. So why do we need to put the day that's been checked? Come on. Imagine you had to put the hour as well, so I would just be putting, so, day before the exam at 11:59. And come on, buddy. Alright. Oh, okay, I thought he was gonna die, but he hasn't. And it's just like, it's the moral of every story. I think that's going to be the moral of every story in the series, where I think it's going to be terrible, but it actually ends up pretty great. Both with the exam that I think, the creative writing exam, I thought it was going to be terrible. It ended up being good. The Spanish literature presentation, I thought it was going to be horrible. But it ended up being, you know, kind of good. The teacher liked it. And now same thing here. Making an academic essay about the Dream SMP. And how much they have grown through 2020. Like, just trying to be like, oh, COVID was great. My favorite YouTubers got more views. It's no, you don't really think of that as something that you should be proud of, but, you know, I'm making an essay about that anyways. It's like, it's just the life story of college. You think something's gonna be terrible, but it ended up being good. I also am running on 3 hours of sleep. Oh, well. Thank you guys for watching. Bye-bye.